being 40, and I have more anxiety turning 30, honestly.
40? That's a good one.
And you turned 40?
Yes, I did.
So what to do at 40 to look younger than your age?
I'm on such a roll now.
Well, it's this way in which, through microneedling.
You're the type of woman that just gets hotter, with all due respect, as you get older.
At the end of the day, you gotta care about yourself.
What do I do, and what do I see working for my patients who wish to look younger, maintain a youthful glow, and they're around their 40s? It's an absolutely key time to strategize over very simple things you can do to prevent anything dramatic from needing to be done ever. I want you to keep this in mind. Technology is advancing so fast that the longer you kind of hang on to the monkey bars as you're jumping down, technology is getting better, so you'll be able to avoid invasive and surgical procedures. In this video, I'm going to cover a comprehensive approach that's going to include skincare, lab tests, face treatments, and supplements. Let's go. Okay, number one, the key is consistent, skincare routine is absolutely crucial for maintaining a youthful look in your skin. Here's a step-by-step guide for a basic, simple, daily skincare regimen. And if you keep it simple, we call that KISS, keep it simple, stupid. That's what we say in medical school. If you keep it simple, you're likely to follow it. Number one, cleansing. You want to start your day by gently cleansing your face with a mild cleanser to remove any impurities and dirt that's accumulated overnight. I did say dirt because you have pillows. How many of you, comment below, are sleeping with animals? Dogs. I know it's very common. Some people do skip this first step if they truly have sensitive skin, and others are going to double cleanse, especially if you wear a lot of makeup. And I have videos on double cleansing with an oil cleanser first, but get a basic cleanser. And I have one. I'm actually formulating another one I'm very excited about. It's probably a couple of months away from being here, but it does make a difference, because what are you doing? You're prepping your skin for your actives. When my lab is done formulating mine, I'll let you know. Number two, at 40, exfoliation is absolutely key. And I think twice a week is a good number to keep in mind. You wanna exfoliate your skin using a gentle exfoliator to slough off the external dead skin cells and promote cell turnover. Because as we age, that cell turnover, it slows down. And a lot of us are exposed to environmental toxins and dangers that are left on our skin. So exfoliation is key. I actually recently did a video. It created a little bit of controversy, and it was on face shaving. That's a physical type of exfoliation. A lot of people thought that that was going to lead to coarse hair growth, more hair growth on the face. It will not, but there's physical and then there's chemical. The best chemical that I use, that I recommend, and I give to my patients is an alpha hydroxy acid, an AHA cream, because it also will attack browns, it also helps with glow, and it also is proven to help build collagen. So you want all those things. Moisturizing, and I know many of you like to skip this step in terms of buying anything that's a little bit expensive, but it pays off. Applying a hydrating moisturizer to the surface of your skin can help build collagen, elastin. It helps decrease inflammation from your actives. Now, I'm a big fan of hyaluronic acid. I know this is a little controversial, but for my patients in my clinic, when we look at this, it works. Vitamin C, talk about this for a minute, because I know a lot of you believe it needs to be very acidic with a pH of 2 to 3. I make mine more in a moisturizer so it can be a one-step process. Remember, keep it simple. And with the new formulations of vitamin C, they do not need to be acidic. If you're using that serum, the acidic standalone vitamin C might have a little E and ferulic in it, but you know, it's very light, then you are going to need moisturizers after it for most people. And if you want to keep a simple step, use one of the new C formulations like I use in mine. So you have your choices here, but then a retinol. Everyone, in my opinion, should be on a retinol, except those who absolutely can't tolerate it. But if you are on a good one, timed release, that's what I've done with mine, you'll tolerate it. And then it's a matter of getting your dose down. But work on that. It's worth your time. I won't spend a lot of time on sun protection, but by now, by 40, I'm assuming you know the benefits of that. You don't need anything more than a 30, and for those who are going to work or they're doing things, they don't want to have that white cast, a quote-unquote chemical sunscreen is going to be the best. And I know what you're going to say in the comments. I see it all the time. I just laugh. Rajani, I'm doing good. I have no brown spots. I 100% guarantee you, if I have you in my clinic and I grab my camera and I use the special settings and I can look underneath your skin, you have a lot of brown spots. It's just the way it is. Here's a picture, 3D imaging here, and you see the skin looks good. I click a button and I see all the brown spots. I see this in 15, 18, 20 year olds when moms come in with their kids. It's kind of fun for me. Hey, let's just take a picture, see what's there. And we, of course, have a lot of people in their early 20s coming in that don't get any sun, but they do because you're getting it in ways you don't even think about, like through the car windows and through your house. Okay, let's go to labs. Now I'm going to talk about labs. I'm going to talk about some scans that if I were 40, I would get and I recommend to my patients. This is going to be a little controversial, and the reason is the only person looking out for you is you. And hopefully it's why you're on this channel. I'm sharing with you what I do for my patients who I'm very blessed to have, but I want to take great care of them. And these are the things I do. The healthcare system, unfortunately, if they recommended these tests for you, they would go bankrupt. So yes, a lot of people are going to have to pay out of pocket. You're probably not going to get coverage at the ages that I would get these. But if I'm sitting there and I could afford it, I would do it. And yes, people with money tend to live longer and look better because they have the money and they can spend it on those things. So if you have to work a little bit extra, if you have to put in overtime and you spend your money on these things, in my opinion, it's worthwhile. But remember, big pharma and healthcare systems can't recommend these because they would go bankrupt. Because if you move the screening age from, say, we're going to talk about a DEXA scan, 65 years of age, they recommend that. Let's say they move it to 50. If you look at the graph of the masses, which is all they care about, they would have to spend X billion dollars more a year, and they don't want that. They probably want it in their corporate pockets. I'm not an anti-corporate guy, and I am a free market capitalist, but when it comes to healthcare, the fact that we're like ranked 30th in the world and we're a top country, it's atrocious. So monitoring your health through lab tests, in my opinion, is essential for maintaining overall well-being and tackling any underlying issues that may impact your health before they impact your health. Because, as you know, prevention is way better than cure. Number one, hormone levels. A survey of 2,000 American women aged 30 to 60 found that nearly half, so 47% in that study, experienced the symptoms of a hormonal imbalance. And here's the worst part. Results suggested that many of these women were unaware of the potential implications of hormones. So they didn't know that the hormones were causing their symptoms. And 2% did find out after that it was the causative factor of their symptomatology, meaning there's zero awareness of this. I recommend ask your mom if she's available. At what age did she have menopause, period changes, and what were hormones like? Because there is a big genetic component to this. What do you want to request? A comprehensive hormone panel. You want to get your estrogen, testosterone, and thyroid done. And a TSH screening is not enough. I did a complete video on tests that your doctor's not ordering. You can look that up, or I'll put a link below. And you can see exactly on thyroid the things that you want to look for on testing. So maintaining your hormonal balance, it can preserve that youthful look because estrogen affects your fat pads, your skin, and your dermal thickness. Low estrogen is one of the biggest causes for thinning of the skin, which leads to wrinkles. And then people go get more Botox, and Botox is only a Band-Aid. It's important to note that the exact percentage of women experiencing hormone changes at the age of 40, it varies depending on, of course, individual factors and genetics and environmental and lifestyle factors. So everyone's going to be different, but why wouldn't you want to have a baseline level? So if in 5 to 7, 8 years from now, you're not feeling right, you knew what you were at 40. That's the key here. What about vitamin levels and mineral levels? Get your vitamin D, your vitamin B12, and your iron levels checked. These nutrients play a vital role in skin health and can protect your overall energy levels, most importantly, your bone. What about inflammation markers? Request a C-reactive protein or CRP test. That's going to measure inflammation levels in your body. Chronic inflammation accelerates everything. You know this from your dry eye, from your hair loss, from your skin, from your aging, your joints. It affects everything. You want to know your inflammatory markers. I recommend a cardiac calcium scan because heart disease, let's look at it this way. What if you could get rid of the top five killers? So men and women are going to be different, but number one for both is going to be heart disease. What if you could take away the top five things that may kill you? Now I know we're talking aesthetics here, but in aesthetics, we're going to talk about supplements and we're going to talk about facial bone. You want to maintain both, but calcium gets put, we want it in our face and our bone. Face meaning the bone in her face and the bone in her body, but you don't want it in your vessels. We're going to talk about that in a minute with regards to the face, but keep in mind, while we're talking scans, we're going to talk cardiac calcium scan. And interesting, if you're a Netflix watcher, go watch something called The Widowmaker. It's fascinating and it talks about this cardiac calcium scan. It was $99. I ran into a nurse friend yesterday at the coffee shop. She said they're now $200. I'm booking mine. And they don't do them at a lot of hospitals because they don't make money. And cardiologists love doing catheterization and opening up vessels. That's how they're driving around in their Ferraris. I had no problem with that. But that's what this movie talks about, The Widowmakers. And I think it is fascinating, the fact that people aren't doing these scans, but rather do interventions. Get a baseline cardiac calcium scan. It's inexpensive. Bone scanning. Women, you live longer. Why not have a great spine and have a fun life right up until the age when you die? And to do that, you need mobility, but women lose bone. Think estrogen, think calcium, vitamin D problems, and of course, hormonal balance problems. So a DEXA scan. Now the National Osteoporosis Foundation recommends people at average risk get the scan at guess what age? You ready? 65. Okay, by 65, you're almost dead. 65, average woman says lives, let's just say it's 79, but I think that's because of recent problems we had over the last few years. But let's just go 80 as an average number. It's probably 82, 83 realistically. Let's say 80. You have 15 years left. I personally would be getting one in the 40s. And if there's family history of osteoporosis, if there's early menopause, if you've had your ovaries out, if you have dietary challenges, even earlier. What's wrong with having a baseline and someone telling you at 40, your DEXA scan's perfect. You keep doing what you're doing and you get it at 50 again. But it's way, in my opinion, way too late at 65. I mean, come on. That makes no sense. So we have these tests available. We should do them. Let's talk face treatments. Okay, professional face treatments can provide an extra boost to your skincare routine. At 40, you want to consider these treatments to enhance your youthful appearance. You don't want anything too extreme. You don't want to lose your facial fat. You don't want too much heating, yet you want maintenance and prevention. Number one, chemical peels. Chemical peels help remove dead skin. They can exfoliate. They reduce fine lines, improve texture. You want to have a specialist do it. You don't want to go too deep. Go for a combination peel like the VI peel. You don't need a phenol peel or something crazy. In fact, you don't want that. That's going to lead to more problems. Microdermabrasion, you're all going to ask me. It's one of the most popular treatments as outlined by the American Society of Plastic Surgery. They do surveys every year and it shows microdermabrasion one of the top ones. These are, I've done thousands back in the day, in the early 2000s, they were popular. They can cause problems, they can cause vessels to come to the surface, they can ruin your skin barrier. How do they work best? Before a peel or as maintenance after? Before regular microneedling, not microneedling RF, but regular microneedling and after. But as standalone treatments by 40, if you're just going in to get microderms, I'm not a big fan. There's better things you can do. Let's talk laser treatments. Okay, you all want to know about lasers. They're great. You need an expert, someone who does them all the time. But the one you're looking for is called erbium YAG. Now that's basically talks about what the technical specifications of the laser. So you can say, Rajani, what's an erbium YAG? Well, the two that you're gonna know about are like erbium YAG or CO2. So erbium yag, think 2940 nanometers. Fraxel, you all know Fraxel, it's been around a long time. You should not have to pay a lot of money to get a Fraxel. The original one was 1550 nanometers in wavelength. There's the dual, been around a long time, that adds 1920 to it, gets brown spots a little bit more. They're all over the place and you shouldn't cost you a lot of money and they're very safe. You know, Cyton, you're going to tell me about the Jewel. That is a Jewel platform. There's Alma. There's different type of lasers. But in general, a wavelength like that that's targeting water will help with brown spots and also help with some skin tightening. Again, you need to see an expert because every great device can cause great problems or it can give great results. So devices that have zero risk have zero results. It's just the way it works. But lasers work great and it's something you should consider. I'll add IPL, intense pulse light. It's a broad spectrum of light, flashes. Again, it can be very dangerous, but it's great. And the reason is you also get reds with it. So at 40, people tend to get a little bit of rosacea. IPL is great for that. And in general, the machines are, I had, I think, 8 IPLs back in 2005, 6, 7 in multiple locations. Now they're way safer. But people don't think now. A great majority of people providing these services are not trained or they're working one day a week or they're having off, quote unquote, off days. You never have an off day. You don't go to work if you have an off day. Do you want to be there on an off day? Never. So if you go to work, you show up, you're focused, you do the best job you can, you want to find someone with that mental attitude. In terms of treatment, the next one would be platelet-rich fiber, and I talk about that all the time. That's when you draw your blood, you spin it down, get your exosomes, stem cells, and growth factors. A great thing to do at 40. The other thing I do by 40, for especially men, but women, especially thicker, oilier skin, I do Sculptor in the upper face 100% of the time, because then we don't get the sag. It's very preventive, and I might do one and not do it for 3 to 5 years. At that age, if people maintain their bone, they're on supplements and great food, but getting a single dose in there at 40 is saving. It's saving treatments down the road that are more invasive. Let's talk supplements. So exercise and supplements are key. What supplements should you be on by 40? Why do you even need supplements? Number one, first and foremost, eat real food. Number two, eat enough. And you want to be at a healthy weight. You don't want to be too thin and you don't want to be overweight. So you want to be at a healthy weight. But the food supply isn't what it was. The animals aren't eating what they used to. Often they're eating, the nutrients they're taking in are the nutrients you're going to get through them. And often they're not good. It's not like they're roaming around like they used to be eating normal food. They're eating grains and feed. So supplements for many people are necessary, in my opinion. And if I'm eating at home healthy, I back off on my supplements because I'm eating well. The fact is, when I'm on the road, I'm not eating as well, or I fall off the wagon here or there, I go to social events. So supplementation maintains the right levels. Number one, omega-3 fatty acids, such as what? I get mine from krill oil, not fish oil. And I know when I'm not eating fish, so I particularly make sure I'm taking them then. But krill oil is more sustainable and it has something called astaxanthin, which is one of the most powerful antioxidants on earth. But what do omega-3s do? They maintain your skin elasticity, reducing inflammation. I think that's one of the key measures. And you know that because inflammation's leading to your dry eye, your hair problems, your nail problems, and omega-3s help with that, and they're quite proven. They're also cardioprotective, so while you're getting your calcium scan, you're also thinking about this. Number two, vitamin K2D3. So vitamin K2D3. Now, K2 is not K1. K2 is a specific form of vitamin K. It's not involved in clotting. And vitamin D3, again, a specific form of vitamin D. In your foods fortified with vitamin D, that's going to be D2. But K2D3 allows your calcium absorbed in the gut to go into your bone. Where do you need bone at 40? In your face is one, because when you see someone and you don't recognize them. Maybe you haven't seen them in 10 years. Look at what it is you don't recognize about them. It's the bony structural change of their face. And what happens when you get a facelift doesn't change your bone. We can mimic the bone with things like Sculptor, with like fillers, but not a facelift. A facelift removes skin and tightens the skin. So maintain your bone with K2-D3. It's also cardioprotective. Number three is a collagen powder. The collagen only comes from animals. There's more and more studies on it, and they show exactly what it does for hair, for nails, and in this case, we're talking wrinkles and skin. It gives you glow, and it's been proven now to absorb in the body. A lot of people said before, collagen does not absorb. I have videos of studies on that. The bottom line, my patients take it, they love it, and they look better for it. I don't want anyone on Sculptra if they're not on collagen powder and my fourth vitamin, which is my Plasma Restore, and you can be on whatever ones you're on, but here are the components of that. Vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin E, and silica. And that's in my Plasma Restore gummies, but they all support collagen production. Because you start to lose collagen like this at 40, and the more you maintain, the more you hold on, the less you ever need done. Number five is Women's Vitality Blend. So for a lot of you, we talked about hormone imbalance. You're not on, not at the point where certainly you need hormone replacement therapy. Maybe you never want to take hormones. That's totally fine. But there are things you can take like ashwagandha, Tomcat LE, horny goat weed. There's many things that support your hormonal balance and that have mild effects to increase and boost your hormones. And I'm a proponent of those. And there are naturally ways to do it. And that's one of them. I have to talk about sleep, and I'm a melatonin fan, because when you see someone and they look rested and you say to them, you look good, what are you doing? I'm finally sleeping. If you're not sleeping, you're not getting REM sleep, you'd never have glow. And so if you can't sleep the odd night, you need melatonin. We now know how well melatonin works and the fact that you do not become used to it so that you become physically dependent on it. And we do know that you get a good quality of sleep on it. If you're one of those people that get nightmares you can't deal with, less than 1%, don't take it. If you're one of those people, you feel hungover in the morning, here's what's happening. You're on a bad form of melatonin and the dose is way higher than what it's saying. All you need is 5 milligrams, maybe 10 milligrams, buy real product, because a lot of the melatonins have, they might say 5 or 10 milligrams and you're getting 40 or 50. Or not enough. So be on a quality melatonin, but whatever you gotta do, watch my sleep hygiene videos. At 40, get your sleep in control. One of the things that's been shown with poor sleep, especially in women over time, is memory loss. And this is one of those associations that seems like it's going to explode on the research front to show exactly how the brain resets at nighttime in deep sleep. And when it doesn't reset, over time, it never fully resets and your cognition goes. We're going to find out how important sleep is, but especially for women, for hormone balance too. So you know about your serotonin. So many people are on SSRI, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors or antidepressants. That scares me too, because I do think we're gonna come to find out that there's long-standing effects of those that aren't good. So do everything as natural as possible, rather than taking a lot of pharma. Now you're gonna wanna watch this video all about HRT or bioidentical hormone replacement, just so you're geared up. And I put a video down here on how to boost your collagen at home. Stay tuned, keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.